Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, I'm Ishwarya. I do videos on lifestyle, beauty, travel, just anything and everything that I like. So if you're new here, hi, if you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Also ring the notification bell, you know the drill. Anyway, today's video is going to be all about the Nykaa Skin Shield Anti-Pollution Foundation. Now, this is not a new launch in any way. I think it's been more than a year that this has been launched, but a year back I was not on YouTube and I always wanted to try it, but I never ended up trying it. But then I finally, you know, bought it and tried it because I wanted to do a review for you guys and tell you right off the bat it's a good product. But that does not mean that you don't see the video, watch the whole video. But yeah, so let's get started with the review of the Nykaa Skin Shield Anti-Pollution Foundation. Okay, so let's start with the basics. Retails for 799 rupees for a 30 ml bottle. I got it on a discount. I think I got it for like 500 rupees. So yeah, Nykaa always has discounts on their product, so try and buy it during a sale time. It'll be a good deal. Comes in a tube packaging like this. That is how it looks. Nothing really fancy. Just now, this foundation comes in a total of 15 shades, which is a very good start. It's a very good start and it shows that the brand is trying to be inclusive of all the skin tones that are there in India. 15 shades is not a huge variety of shades in no way, but I think it's a good start and it'll get better with time. So they have categorized all of their shades into 5, 5, 5. 5 for really fair skin tones, 5 for medium to wheatish skin tones, and 5 for the dusky and chocolatey skin tones. Now, I don't think all the shades can fit in 5 shades, like the fair, medium and the dusky skin tone. But the way they've categorized it, it's good, you know, giving equal number of shades to all the categories. It's a very nice way of categorizing things. So 5, 5, 5. That is total of 15 shades. I am in the shade 10 Golden Hour. It's supposed to be a semi-matte satin finish foundation and it is that. You will see it in the video. It's not completely matte. As you guys know, I like a really matte drying foundation. I already have very dry skin. I like a very dewy finish foundation. This is not dewy in any way, but it's not really matte. It's a semi-matte finish. If you have oily skin tone, it can look a little satiny, but because I'm really dry, it still looks very matte on me. But I think on oily skin tones, it'll give a really beautiful satin effect. That's why I've not set my foundation at all, because I like the dewiness to come out. It has a triple action formula, which is the anti-pollution, deep hydration and oil control action. We'll see that with time. Anti-pollution, I don't know how can a foundation help in anti-pollution sort of a thing, so I don't know about that. And when it comes to deep hydration, I can't say it's very hydrating because it's a matte, kind of semi-matte foundation. I think for oily skin people, if you do not moisturize that much, you can still get away with it. So yeah, it is a little hydrating, it's not extremely matte. And about the oil control action, that we'll get to know as the day goes by. So those were the basics. Now, coming to my opinion on this foundation, I really, really like the foundation. I really, really like the shade. It's a perfect, perfect shade. Again, I'm in the shade 10 Golden Hour. I think it matches me so beautifully. That's all that I have on my face and a little bit of bronzer. No concealer, nothing. You'll see it in the demo. As you can see, the formula is a thick, creamy formula, not very runny. And it's a perfect match for me, 10 Golden Hour. I'll be doing one side with the beauty sponge and the other side with the brush. And nowadays, I've been liking using a brush, which is really new for me. But yeah, just thought I would tell that to you guys. As you can see, it blends out like a dream. It's not starky, it's not cakey looking. It literally blends beautifully. Using the PAC 265 foundation blending brush. So what I'm doing here is I'm building up the product as concealer. I just wanted to see how it builds up. It doesn't get really cakey. Also wanted to show you guys that if you do not want to use it as a foundation, you can use it as a concealer on a daily basis and just skip the whole foundation part. And that is how my skin is looking after the whole application. This has medium coverage. If you're looking for a full coverage foundation, this is not it. even after building it up under my eyes, as you saw, it still looks very sheer and my blemishes are peeking through. It is not a full coverage foundation, it's a medium coverage foundation. It's buildable, it does not take up. So yeah, if you're looking for a full coverage foundation, this is not it. It's a very, very nice foundation. Also would be perfect for oily skin girls. It is 3 o'clock right now and the foundation has come out from here, but all in all, it still looks quite okay. I've become shiny here. I had no highlighter today, but I've still become shiny, so it's starting to get a little oily, but all in all, it looks quite okay. It is night time right now and this is how the foundation is looking. Now I did, if you can hear Scotch snoring, please don't mind, he's sleeping. I did get oily, okay, like I really got oily here, and as you can see, the foundation is off from here. You can start seeing the blemishes here, though it's completely off, and here it's a little bit off, but all in all, it still looks very good. Now I did get really oily, especially here, and I'm a dry skin girl. And I also didn't set the foundation because I didn't feel like it requires to be, you know, like set. Also, it has settled in my lines, if you can see very clearly. It has settled. But I think all foundations do that, especially matte ones. But that is how it's looking. I think my skin still looks pretty nice and pretty, I'm still getting a little oily, as you can see. Yeah, that's how the foundation fared. So yeah, I really hope you guys like this video. I hope you guys like got to know a new foundation. It's not new, I know that, but then I generally don't buy things the moment it's out, and also I was not on YouTube last year. I'm repeating myself, but yeah, that is how the foundation fared. I hope you guys like this video. If you liked it, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. You know the drill, and I'm gonna catch you really soon in my next video. Bye.